Hey gang, Jack Allaire here, and today I'm sharing some of the highlights of my first playthrough of Baldur's Gate 3. If you want to watch the gameplay without edits, there'll be a link in the description of this video. Once I started the game, the opening cinematic started to play, and it set the tone of being completely powerless. I saw a mind flayer, one of the scariest things in D&D, as it placed a parasite in a gith a few pods over, and then it came over to my pod and put one into my eye. And instantly this brought me to the character creation menu that had a lot of options. This playthrough, I decided to go easy and play one of my old characters that was first used in a campaign during the late 1990s while I was still in the army. Kaleb, a half-elven bard, was raised by his mother and father, and they were both fairly high up in the Thieves Guild. I took the criminal background as this seemed to make the most sense for what his background actually is. This was also fitting as Kaleb is a character that got introduced to the Mind Flayers a few years ago in a different incarnation during a home game. Then the game wanted me to make a guardian, which I still barely understand, so I made a nice half-orc and then carried on with the game. The cutscene continued with the ship opening up and starting to steal people from a city below. And it didn't take long for some gith-riding dragons to show up and start ruining the Mind Flayer's day. After a game of cat and mouse, I eventually awakened in the Hells on a badly damaged Nautiloid, which is the Mind Flayer ship. The first thing I managed to do once awake was inspect a pool that the angry tadpole came from and got it to explode. And when I moved to the next room, I tried to play doctor, but since I'm a bard, that didn't go well either. As I stepped out onto a walkway, I was nearly killed by the same gith that had already escaped during the cutscene. She quickly explained that both of us would end up becoming Mind Flayers unless we followed her plan. Not having a better plan of my own, I settled in and got ready to kill some imps and hijack a Nautiloid. What followed was a fairly low-stakes battle with some imps that taught me the basics of combat. I was really shocked to find someone else still alive in one of the pods. I tried pushing some buttons, which only led to bad things happening, but in the next room I found what looked like something that might open the door of the pod. After returning and opening it, Shadowheart had joined my party. The room after that was thick with battle between denizens of the Hells and Mind Flayers. Our job was simply to turn on the teleport drive again while surviving the battle around us. It turned into a race, once again proved that Kaleb should never be allowed to touch anything. The ship managed to crash, and just as I was falling to my doom, something caught me. And this is where we'll leave it for the first bit of the game. We have escaped. We are on our own in a strange place. And hopefully we can find out what's going on with us later on. I appreciate you watching this far in the video, and I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section. And I look forward to continuing this playthrough as the year continues. Thank you for watching, and as always, play on!